身为美国前国防部长，卡内塔曾在奥巴马任内执行美国重返亚洲政策，并在与中国互动上扮演重要角色。在中共十九大开幕当天，听完习近平演说，随即接受 CNN 主持人阿曼波专访，坦言美中两国至于全球的影响力确实正此消彼长。
Been told that the Chinese have been quite reluctant to declare global domination, so to speak. Do you think that President Xi took a major leap forward today?
I don't think there's any question that President Xi sees a vacuum that has been created by the United States. I think President Xi has made very clear that the Chinese are going to move forward. They're going to move forward on climate change. They're going to move forward with their economy. Obviously, his whole speech was dedicated to greater discipline within China itself. So it appears that he's going to provide leadership for China that may make the 21st century the century belonging to China.
What does China have, and what would a China, you know, China-led, dominated world look like?
What China has right now is a strong economy, and if they're prepared to move in a global world, recognizing that we are a global world, that it is a world in which we are interconnected financially and by trade, by security, by a number of factors, then China, I think, is...recognizing the realities of the world we live in. And unfortunately, I think what President Trump is doing is not recognizing those realities. We are in a global world. This is not a time when the United States can withdraw in terms of leadership in the world, and yet that's what's happening. The real question, I think, is going to be whether or not China can sustain that. After all, they are a communist government.They do try to exercise tremendous control. Will their internal stability allow them to assert the kind of power that President Xi is talking about? I think those are real questions for the future.
Other questions are, what does it mean for global human rights? We've seen President Xi remain committed to trade, to the climate accords, to the Iran nuclear deal. But in terms of people's freedoms, in terms of exporting, I mean, the kind of democratic, political pluralism, we saw again at the Congress that actually there was no mention of any kind of political opening or any letup in the crackdown on any kind of dissent there.
Well, and I think that represents a real weakness in terms of whether or not China can sustain world leadership. You know, the fact is that the United States was a world leader because of our values, because of what we represented in terms of freedoms and liberties, the dignity of the individual, the ability to self-govern.And be able to enjoy democratic principles. I mean, that's what the United States was all about. Mm-hmm. That's not what China is about. Mm-hmm. China is about pushing economic prosperity. I mean, they do have a strong economy. They can engage in trade. They can make steps to basically go into areas involving climate control, et cetera. So,Yeah, they can take advantage of this moment, but I think the real question is, how long can that be sustained with a country that really doesn't share the kind of values that the rest of the world wants to embrace?